Hi guys, Pragyan here, currently a first year MBBS student at AIIMS New Delhi, and welcome back to our channel and welcome back to a brand new episode of Spilling Out Secrets. And today with us we have Vaidehi Jha, who secured all India rank 21 in NEET this year. So first of all, congrats Vaidehi for this great feat.
Thank you, sir.
So without wasting any time, let's begin with this episode. And yes, before I begin, let me tell you that we also have a fun rapid fire round towards the end of this video. So do watch the entire video. So now let's start with the academic questions. So Vaidehi, the first question for you is that tell us about your NEET preparation journey in short.
I started preparing for NEET in 11th. I studied for it for 2 years and it was not always very smooth. There were a lot of ups and downs and mostly there were a lot of downs because I used to feel low if I didn't score very well and I used to get demotivated. But I pushed through because I wanted to get into AIIMS and I did. So I would suggest everyone to just be calm and not take it too seriously. And it does get better.
Yeah, great. So what was your biggest mistake during your preparation?
I would say not reading the NCERT from the beginning, because in 11th, I did not pay much attention to the NCERT, especially bio. And then in the later stages, I had to read it several times within a short span. So that got hectic.
Right. So now let's talk about your subject-wise preparation strategy. So let's start with chemistry.
Chemistry, I thought was my weakest subject, so I gave more time to it. For inorganic, I stuck to the NCERT. I remembered all the examples given in the NCERT. For organic, the mechanisms and the intermediates in the NCERT are important. And solving the questions at the back of the book is also very important because the reactions are often repeated. And when you solve it many times, they get engraved in your brain. So you don't really need to do much to remember them. And for physical chemistry, I solved numericals, which was the fun part.
So what were the books that you followed for each of them?
I didn't follow a lot of extra books. I just did the Akash modules and the NCERT. I did the NEET Challenger app and MTG's NCERT at your fingertips.
Okay, great. So now let's talk about your bio preparation strategy.
For bio, I would say stick only to the NCERT, but you have to remember every detail given there between the lines, below the diagrams, everywhere, every word is important. I stuck to the modules for that, NCERT and MTG's NCERT at your fingertips.
Okay, so how many times you read the bio NCERT?
I didn't read as many times as most people do. I've heard that you have to read it around 10 to 15 times, but I think I only read it around 5 times. Maybe I should have read a bit more.
No, of course, this number is variable and it is different for everyone. And if you can gather all that information in just 5 readings, then it's well and good. And some people may require 15 readings to get that same information and to learn the stuff. And how many times you read the chemistry NCERT?
Only once or twice, not much.
Okay, great. So that means you had great grasping skills.
Yeah.
And now let's talk about your physics strategy.
Physics is my favorite subject. So I would make sure that all my concepts got cleared in the class itself because that made solving the numericals very easy and actually very fun. I would also make short notes of all the formulas in a separate book after the chapter was over. And before tests, I would refer only to those and solve as many questions as possible. All the questions behind the NCERT are also very important.
Okay, so the books which you followed for physics?
The same Akash modules, NCERT, and MTG's NCERT at your fingertips.
Okay, great. So how many full syllabus mock tests you gave before the final exam?
Around 40 days before the main NEET exam, I did a question paper every day and sometimes even 2 or 3. So I would say I've given around 60 mock tests of full syllabus.
Great. And now talking about the previous year paper. So till which year you solved the PYQs?
Till around 2010, I would say, not a lot.
Right. So any tips for error analysis?
Yeah, and error analysis is a very important part. I would make sure that I did that after every test and made a separate book for that. And I referred to those before NEET, like a week before NEET. So that is very important because it's okay to make mistakes, but it's not okay to repeat those mistakes.
Rightly said. So if not MBBS, what you would have pursued?
I think I would like to be a pilot. So maybe that, aviation.
Okay, great. Were you away from social media during your prep?
No, I was on Instagram. I wasn't very active, but I wasn't away from it.
Okay, so how did you manage? Like you specified some time for it in your day.
Yeah, I made sure that I didn't spend a lot of time there, but sometimes I couldn't control. Then I would feel guilty about wasting a lot of time. So, but self-control has to be there. If you're determined, then you'll be able to.
Or better is just like, don't have an Instagram. You can use WhatsApp for asking doubts to your teachers.
Yeah, that's also one way.
Yeah, but if you have, then you have to allot the time to your studies and your hobbies. So how did you keep yourself motivated?
I would give time to hobbies also because that was a nice break from all the studying, and every Sunday I would watch a movie with my family, and these little routines that made me refreshed. And I would give a lot of TED Talks to myself. That is the only way I thought it actually worked. Talk to your friends, your family. That is also very helpful.
Okay, so what did you do in your leisure time? Like, what were your hobbies?
I used to write a lot and I'd watch movies and shows.
Okay, so Vedehi, the next question for you is that, what was your paper attempting strategy?
I always started from physics because I felt most comfortable getting away with the harder part. I solved physics in around 1 hour 15 minutes, then chemistry in 45 minutes, and bio in 40 minutes. And then I would recheck my paper and see if there were any questions I had a doubt in, and if I have left any questions.
And what about the OMR?
I would bubble after each subject. So physics, chemistry, and then bio as botanies work together.
And any strategy for section B?
I would read all the questions and answer all of the questions, and then I would choose the 10 that I was most sure about. But if the time was less, then I would just see which is the easiest one at a glance and then do those.
Nice. So like you told before that you prepared short notes. So what would you suggest how to prepare them?
For physics, I would say just write all the formulas, every formula in every chapter. And go through those several times because at the end there are so many formulas that it's tough to remember them. For chemistry, I had written the reactions, but I wasn't very frequent with revising those, so it was an issue at the end for inorganic. So I would say that go through those regularly. And for bio, I didn't really have any short notes.
Okay, so for bio, you revise the NCERT entirely?
Directly from the book.
Great. So what was your daily routine and how many hours you studied per day?
I studied around 8 hours apart from coaching. I didn't wake up very early, like super early, but around 7-8 I would start. From 11 to 4 we had our coaching classes online. So after that I would study from around 5, sometimes till 12 or 1.
Great. Of course, having breaks in between, like for...
Yeah, obviously. Sometimes very long breaks.
Yeah, you told before. Describe your feelings after securing only rank 21 and knowing that you will enter AIIMS.
When I got the result, I was very shocked because I didn't expect such a good rank. But now that I've had time to realize it, I am very excited to join AIIMS because who doesn't want to join AIIMS? And I'm very excited to just explore and find out more about the world and about myself.
Okay, and what were the events that unfolded on the day of result of NEET?
The result came out quite late, so everyone in my house was asleep. I was watching a movie when I got the result, and I was very panicked at that time. I woke my parents up and everyone started cheering and laughing and I started crying. And then we called our relatives and it all happened very quickly. It was very overwhelming.
Okay, so you saw the result yourself. Yeah, like you were alone, yes, right? Seeing the result. Okay. So now we come to an end to this section of the video. Now it's time for the fun section, the rapid fire round. So Vedehi, are you ready?
Yes.
The first one is your most favorite and least favorite subject.
Most favorite physics, least favorite botany.
Okay. Give one word for physics.
Interesting.
One word for botany.
Boring.
Something you sacrifice during NEET preparation.
Hangout time with friends.
Favorite color.
Blue.
Favorite movie and web series.
Web series Squid Game, and movie. I have many. The movie Run.
Okay. Your actor crush.
Matt Smith.
Okay. Your favorite food?
Pasta.
So the next question is complete the names of these chapters according to NCERT. So the first one is ray optics and dash.
Optical instruments.
Correct. Dash in food production.
Use of microbes?
No. Is that really a chapter? I don't think so.
I don't remember.
It is strategies for enhancement.
These for enhancement food production, yeah.
Biodiversity and dash.
Conservation.
Yeah, biodiversity and its conservation. Correct. Dual nature of dash.
Matter. And
no.
Radiation.
Yeah, it's dual nature of radiation and matter. So you scored decently well in this as well. Your favorite song?
Betty by Taylor Swift.
The best gift which you ever received?
My sister got me Nike shoes.
Okay. After NEET?
Yes.
Great. Your inspiration?
My mother.
Great. So Vedehi, as you scored 705, so which three questions you got wrong?
One of them was in physics, a graph question. Another in chemistry, a Frenkel defect question. And the one in botany, that the anatomy question.
Right, in which all the options were correct.
Yeah.
Is that question also doubtful, the Frenkel one? Like ambiguous
question? A few doubtful, but I think it was from the NCERT and I had missed out.
Okay, fine. So Vedehi, any final message which you want to give to the future aspirants?
I would say that don't worry too much. It's not the end of the world if you don't perform well. And there's always hope ahead. So be positive.
Yes, rightly said. So guys, with this, we come to an end to the rapid fire round and to the video as well. I hope that all of you guys got to learn a lot from Vedehi herself. And so that's it for today's video. Thanks for watching and don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Signing off. Bye-bye.